Now, understand as to what is a put option and how does it work. Now, remember, what is a call option? Call option is a right and not an obligation. What is a right? The right, as we saw in the example of Reliance Industries, it is a right for the holder of the call option to purchase the given quantity of the shares, 100 in our example, from the seller of the option. And that means what? As we discussed earlier, you as the buyer of the option only have a right, you have no obligation. Same is the case with the put option also. Then what is the difference between the call option and the put option? The difference between the call option and put option is very simple. Call option gives you a right to purchase and put option gives you a right to sell. Right? So call option gives you a right to purchase and a put option gives you a right to sell. And remember, both of them, whether it is a call option or a put option, both of them give you a right without any obligation. And for purchasing this right, you will pay a premium. Now, how will the put option work? Let's understand. Now you are holding shares of Maruti. And currently, Maruti is trading about, I think, 5,000 rupees. So let's say 5,000 rupees. Now, currently Maruti is trading at 5,000 and you have a fear. What is the fear? Fear is, considering the current scenario, it is possible that the Maruti share may further go down. And let's say, for the sake of example and understanding, you think Maruti's share will go down to 4,500. And again, you are currently holding 100 shares of Maruti. So how do you take care of this risk? The one way of taking care of this risk is you sell the shares of Maruti, 100 shares of Maruti that you are holding, as you are fearing or as you are apprehending that Maruti will go down by 500 rupees. So what is the option that you have if you want to save yourself off that risk? You sell the Maruti shares today. But you sell the Maruti share today at 5,000 and tomorrow, contrary to your belief, contrary to your assumption, instead of Maruti going down, tomorrow Maruti went up by 5,000, by 500 rupees, and it became 5,500 rupees. So what is the consequence? The consequence is you have suffered a loss of 500 rupees. How do you safeguard it? How do you safeguard this risk? At the same time, take the benefit of the situation. So you do it by purchasing a put option. And remember, as I said earlier, what is a put option? Put option gives you right to sell. Put option gives you right to sell. So let's say you purchase a put option. And remember, whenever you are purchasing a put option or call option, you have to pay a premium, you have to pay a price. So remember, in a way, I'm sure this would be very interesting for you to understand, in a way, purchasing a put option or call option is something like purchasing an insurance policy. So when you purchase an insurance policy, why do you purchase an insurance policy? You purchase an insurance policy because you want to cover the risk. And for covering the risk, you obviously pay a premium. Likewise, in case of options also, when you are purchasing the option, you are covering your risk. And for covering the risk, you have to pay a premium. So you purchase a put option. Now what this put option gives you? This put option gives you a right. Right to what? Right to sell. Right to sell what? Right to sell Maruti's 100 shares that you are holding today. At what price? The price at which you have bought the put option. And let's say that you have purchased the put option at a price of 5,000, which is the current price. So you have purchased a put option at the current price of 5,000 rupees. And remember, the shares are with you. Shares have not gone anywhere. You only have purchased the put option. Now, as you expected, Maruti really goes down tomorrow or within the time horizon that you have estimated. So you estimated in 1 month's time, Maruti will go down by 500 rupees. And really, Maruti went down by 500 rupees and it became 4,500 rupees. So how have you saved yourself? You have saved yourself by purchasing this put option. And what is this put option? This put option is, it has given you a right to sell 100 shares of Maruti at a price of 5,000 rupees on the expiry of the option. So on the expiry of the option, even though the market price, the spot price in the market is 4,500 rupees, because you have a put option, you have a right to sell Maruti on the date of expiry to the seller of this option at a price of 5,000 rupees. So that means what? That means he will pay you the difference of 500 rupees. So what you have lost on the price of the shares that you are holding, you have been able to make up that loss by signing this put option. So this is your put option. And remember, it can not only help you to cover your risk, but it can also offer you an opportunity to make profit. And how do you make profit? Let's say Maruti, instead of going down by only 500 rupees, went down by 700 rupees. So what is your loss? So what is going to happen is that it is going to give you an opportunity in one way to cover the loss, and it will also give you an opportunity to make gain also. How will that happen? We will understand in the course of time. So remember, there are parties to an option. So that is something very, very crucial and critical. So who are the parties in case of the option? So remember, you are buying a call option and or you are buying a put option. So obviously, when you are buying a put option or when you are buying a call option, somebody is selling it to you. Now, all this is happening on a stock exchange. Therefore, you will not know as to who is selling the option to you or who is selling the call option to you or who is selling the put option to you, but somebody is selling it to you. So the options, whether it's call option or it is put option, they will have two parties. One is you and second is the writer of the option or seller of the option. So the person who is selling the option, he is known as seller of the option, or he is also referred to as writer of the option. So I am sure, friends, it must be very clear to you today at this point in time. Buyer has a right but no obligation, and therefore buyer has a potential of gain which is unlimited but loss is limited. And how the buyer has the potential of unlimited gain? So you purchase a call option in Reliance Industries at a strike price of 1800 rupees. Tomorrow lines can become 3000, 4000, 5000. I'm just giving you an exaggerated example, so it can go to any extent. And therefore, your potential to make gain is unlimited, but your loss is limited. And what is your loss? Your loss is limited to the extent of the premium that you pay. So in case, contrary to your view, that Reliance would go up, if Reliance comes down on the expiry date, what do you do? You do nothing. You don't do nothing, because if the price has gone up, then you have to exercise the option. if the price has gone down, you do not have to even do that because it's an option. So unless you exercise, nothing is going to happen. And the price has gone down. What is the maximum that you would lose? It is only the amount of premium that you have paid and nothing else. And then you have a seller in case of the option, as I said little while ago. A seller has an obligation but no right. And please, this is what you need to understand and remember. Seller has an obligation, no right. So the person who sold you the call option on Reliance, he is the seller of the call option on Reliance. He has got unlimited loss, but his gain is limited. His gain is limited to the extent of the amount of premium that you would pay. And his loss is unlimited because your gain is his loss. And that is what you need to remember. So in case of options, there are two parties. There is a buyer and there is a seller of the option. So the buyer has got no obligation. Buyer has got only rights. And the seller has got only obligation and no right.